Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and today Apple released iOS 13 Developer Beta 2. This is available now over the air with a beta profile, so you install the profile like you would before, and then check for a software update and install it. If you had beta 1 on your device, it'll be about 691.5 megabytes, give or take a few megabytes. If you had not had iOS 13 previously installed, it will be 4 gigabytes or more. It's usually a really large install the first time, so just keep that in mind. The public beta will not be available until July, according to Apple. They announced that at their keynote, so if you're waiting for the public beta, you'll have to wait a few more weeks for that. They didn't say when in July either. Now, this particular beta has a new build number. Let's take a look at that. The build is 17A5508M, and this particular build brings quite a few little changes and tweaks, and also speeds everything up. And we'll talk about battery life as well in a little bit. Now, the first major change has to do with Haptic Touch. In fact, Haptic Touch seems to be replacing 3D Touch on 3D Touch devices. In iOS 13 Beta 2 on the iPhone XR, it looks like all the icons now have Haptic Touch, just like they would if it was a 3D Touch device. So tap and hold on Twitter, you get all of the same things, music, all of the same features, including notifications as well, have the Haptic Touch enabled. So that works on all the devices. You feel it on the iPhone XR, but on devices like the SE, it works as well. So it works on all the same apps. If we go to weather, it works the exact same way. So that's really nice. Now, one little tweak that they've added is this little icon here. So if you use the voiceover feature that's in settings under accessibility, if you're using this voice control feature to control your device, when you have it on, that little icon's enabled. If you go in, turn it off, takes a moment. There we go. Now the little icon is not there anymore. And that feature is really making that phone's battery drain very fast, and it's quite warm. So if you're going to use voice control, just be aware of that. Now, before I talk about all the other changes and fixes and things like that, Apple has put out a warning for watchOS. If you're going to install the beta or you have beta 1, before you update to beta 2, they said, make sure you have iOS 13 beta 2 installed on your iPhone. Then you can update your watch. If you don't do it in that order, you may have a problem. They have a big important notice on their notes. So keep that in mind. Now, there are many resolved issues. There's 73 or more resolved issues, and that includes things like the SMB connection now works. So if we go into the Files app, now in the Files app, if you tap the three dots here, you can connect to a server. So if you want to connect to a server, it's now available to connect to an SMB server, and that should work just fine. It also supports APFS as well, so keep that in mind. So if you're using that file system, you'll be all set. One tweak they've changed as well is in the Control Center, where you used to have to center press on the 3D Touch or center press the little icon here so that you can get into your different Wi-Fi connections. You no longer have to do that. Now you can just 3D Touch on the little Wi-Fi symbol or the Bluetooth symbol as well to get into this. So before it was a little bit harder to do, you had to press right in the center. Now you can just touch anywhere and it works just fine. So that part's been fixed. Now they've also updated Mail a little bit. So if you have Mail on here and you're using the Apple Mail app, let's go into that. Under the Mail app, if we go to edit, we can select all. For some people, this wasn't there or working with beta 1. It's back and you can select all in all of your different inboxes as well. So if you have a bunch of different inboxes, you can just delete everything if you want to. So that part's really nice. Now, there are 73 plus resolved issues, but there are also 100 plus known issues. So for example, for a period of time after updating to iOS or iPadOS 13 betas, tapping links might cause the apps to become unresponsive, wallpapers may not display correctly, using files in schoolwork isn't supported, and on and on and on. So keep that in mind before you update. Just as a little warning, if you need some of those features, some things may not work, but Apple will continue to work on this. Now, in wallpaper, there's a couple little tweaks, and let's go in there. There's no new wallpaper, but if we go into wallpaper here, and under a wallpaper, when you're choosing one, you've got this dark appearance dims wallpaper. Now, we had this before, but I didn't show it off. So if we turn that on, what happens is it dims and kind of keeps it darker. So you'll see some of these blue lines in here darker. If I turn it back on, it just lightens everything up and keeps the dock different as well. So it's hard to see going back and forth, but I think you get the idea. So you can change it on your own custom wallpaper. So that part's really nice. Also, when you set a wallpaper, so we'll select a wallpaper. When you select a wallpaper, in here you now have the option to turn on or off the parallax effect. So that's the movement effect. When you move the phone side to side and everything moves, you can just turn it off right there. So that part's nice as well. Now for some, I haven't seen this myself, but in Calendar, apparently it has some UI changes. It looks the same to me, but I went in and checked everything and it looks the same. I looked between beta 1 as well. I don't see the tweaks, but for some you may have that. Now there's also new Memoji stickers, so let's take a look at those. Now under Memoji stickers, if we go in here, the ones that Apple creates for you now, we now have fingers crossed right here. We also have a shush. We also have thinking, and there may be a couple new ones as well, but that's what I was able to find, and they'll continue to update this over time. Now within messages, there's some new sounds as far as tap backs go, although I haven't been able to reproduce this, some have. So if you double tap here and do a tap back, some people are actually hearing different sounds for each one of those tap backs. I wasn't able to reproduce this, they all sound the same still, but you may have different sounds for those different tap backs. And then another new feature is when you adjust the volume in certain areas of the OS, if I adjust the volume up and down, the ringer volume here will show in the top where you have the same thing when you turn it to silent. So you've got silent on and off, and then if I unsilence it and then use ringer up and down volume, it shows at the top now. So that's a nice little change as well. Now there's some new settings in the camera. So if we go in the camera under portrait, we now have a couple new options. So if we go all the way to the end, we now have high key light mono. So you'll see that here. If I put the iPhone SE in the background, you can see it's just kind of a mono look, and it looks pretty good. But if we go back to, say, studio light, and then we tap this little button up here, we now can adjust the intensity of the studio light. So we can go back or forth, and it will adjust the lighting in real time on the different image. It's pretty subtle, but you can adjust it, and I'm sure it looks a little bit better on faces. Apple showed this off in their keynote, but we haven't seen it until beta 2. So that's nice that they've added that. Now, apparently this feature only works with iPhone 10 and newer, maybe the 8 Plus and newer, but not in the older phones. The first time you go into the Home app, you're now going to get some new splash screens that say HomePod can now recognize multiple voices. Hit continue. Then you'll get some information about personal requests and using messages and things through the HomePod. And then also you'll get add your profile to Apple TV. So you can create different profiles based on your voice, and you can add them to your Apple TV as well. And then one more, you can update to the latest Apple TV software, and it just lets you know it must be updated in order for this to work. Let's hit continue. And that's new in Home. There's not a whole lot more going on in the Home app though. Now there's some new options under settings. So if we go into settings, and then under settings, if we go down to Safari here, under Safari, we now have show link previews. So that's new. So they'll show previews to links if you want that enabled. Pretty simple and straightforward. Then we have some new options for notes as well. So if we go into notes, and if you have separate languages enabled, it will now show preferred language. So under here, you can select the language. And as long as you have one other language selected, you can go in here and select all of these different languages under notes as well. Although there are some bugs with languages right now, and they may not work properly. Now, aside from that, under notes, there's also another change here where sort checked items. So sort checked items to manually or automatic. So that's a new setting as well. Now, other than that, there is not a whole lot more going on in here, although I did find a change on the iPad and also with voicemail. So I'll show you voicemail and then the iPad change. So if we go into phone, and this is actually a spam voicemail, but you'll see the buttons have changed down here at the bottom. So we have some new buttons. Instead of that little tiny word that said speaker, we now have speaker, phone, and delete. So that's really nice. Now on the iPad, let me show you that. Now on the iPad, pretty much everything's the same that I've gone over with iOS 13, but on iPadOS, with the widgets here on the side, you can now pin widgets. So if I pull down to swipe everything off, the pinned widget stays. So swipe it back on, scroll to the bottom, and go to edit, we can now pin our favorite widget. So maybe we want to pin the calendar, or well, let's pin something different like shortcuts. We'll slide it up here and then we'll hit done. And now if I scroll down, Shortcuts is now pinned as well. And there may be more changes to the iPad, and I'll cover those in a separate video if I find a bunch of them. Now, as far as battery life on beta 1 was great to begin with, and then it got pretty poor after that. So we'll wait for this to load, and you'll see over the last 10 days, battery, I've been using it, this particular device for the past few days, but battery has been about 4 or 5 hours of screen on time with not much battery left. So at the beginning it was great, and then it wasn't. So hopefully this beta is a little bit better. Performance is really good so far. Everything's smooth, but on the iPad it seems to be very buggy. So I've had some issues with that. But other than that, it seems pretty solid. Now, as far as scrolling and opening apps and things, what's weird is that sometimes 3D touch doesn't work here because it's not really 3D touch anymore. It's not pressure sensitive. It's a press and hold. So they've kind of done away with that, which is kind of sad. Now, the other thing too is it seems pretty good, but I still would not recommend installing a beta. It can be really buggy over time, and it's just something I wouldn't really recommend until the public beta is out. Usually it's pretty stable by that point. If you don't mind dealing with bugs, then go ahead and install it. Otherwise, I would avoid it for now. Now, of course, quite a few of you want to see a Geekbench score. I'll just run it on the XS Max for now to see what it's like, and then we'll wrap this up. Geekbench completed, and the single core score was 4,811. Multi-core was 10,967. This is actually a little bit lower than the previous one that was on iOS 13, so that doesn't really mean a whole lot. This could speed up over time, but performance feels much faster than the previous beta. So that's it for this particular one. Of course, I'll link this wallpaper in the description as I always do. If you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe and hit that notification bell if you'd like to see more of these videos. If you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.